So, Steamworks from Vancouver. Have not had this yet. So, yeah, it says we're at 30 IBUs, golden in color. And, wow. Spalter, Tettnanger, and Hallertau. Pilsner malt. And we are at... Sorry. Anyway, I'm having trouble finding that. Let's have a sip first. Okay, smells very authentic. Hella drinkable. Wow, that's pretty good. So established power since 1995. Steam powered. So maybe it's actually steam powered. I don't know if this is where the steam clock is in Vancouver. It says it's on, sorry. I read this before, but I can't remember much. It's 5% alcohol by volume, and it's on, I believe it's Water Street. Having trouble finding that again. Yeah, Water Street, 375 Water Street, Vancouver, British Columbia. Shows the clock there. I know they got a steam clock in Gastown. That's pretty swanky. Yeah, it's quite the aroma. It's kind of got a nice biscuity aroma, like much more so than I can really explain. It's very, very pronounced. Very clean smelling. Vancouver's got excellent soft water, so perfect idea to brew a Pilsner there. There's another Pilsner from Stanley Park. Tastes pretty clean as well. Excellent water for brewing Pilsners. Look how clear that is. Oh yeah, goes down like nothing else. It's very cold right now. It does have a little bit of carbonation to it, but very smooth mouthfeel. You're not getting a lot of carbonation in the mouthfeel. Very smooth, malty, biscuity. This is a spot on Pilsner. This is I'm pretty hard on Pilsners when I rate them too, because there's so many like shitty ones out there. I do like the hops in this a lot, and a lot of times I don't like the way a lot of the Pilsners are hopped, so, that's a really good job, guys. Like, I, commend you on your Pilsner. This is very good. I'm usually not too impressed with most Pilsners. This one's very good. It's a cool can, too. Cool looking building. 500 milliliter can. Yeah, just loving this. Got the orange tab on top. Yeah, the aroma is slightly unusual. I've had it, smelled it before, but not quite this much. It does have a little bit of uniqueness to it. And as for the hops used, Spalter, I'm not familiar with. Tettnanger and Hallertau, I am. But I'm not getting like kind of like Saz to death. You know what I mean? Like, it's not... You are getting that type of profile, but it's a little bit more balanced out, a little bit earthy, a little bit maybe more grassy to kind of balance out the heavy plantiness, and the heavy bitterness is not as pronounced. So it's really a lot of people that like that typically like domestic pale lager, but want to step out to something. This would be a good one, because like some of them pilsners, you're gonna get sazed to death. Like you're gonna get over plantified for a lot of people. It's gonna be too bitter. This is definitely an introductory pilsner, but even for beer snobs, you're not gonna be upset about this beer at all. I think if you at all like pilsners, you will like this beer. Up against Pilsner Urquell, I say it's pretty. This one's much cleaner than that. It's much more crisp, clean, drinkable. You can see how clear it is, how filtered and stuff. The hops are quite a bit different. There is a little more bitterness than you'd get maybe out of an Urquell. It'd be a little more grassy, a little more golden maltiness out of an Urquell. Those are both, this one and the Urquell would be two introductory pilsners, but if you're in the area and you can get this Steamworks one, definitely give this a shot. But it is in that league. Like if you like Pilsner Urquell, you'd probably like this one a lot. This one's at least as authentic as that one, so. I'm curious to see what else these guys brew. I should check their website. Damn, delicious. So as for a rate, pretty damn good. Lacing shot. Incredible mouthfeel. It is quite complex. Like you are getting several layers out of the hops. This was a nice watery. The watery soft water mouthfeel is perfect for this, and basically the malts are kind of in maybe two stages as well. You are kind of getting a couple different things out of the malts, even though it's a straight Pilsner malt, but very biscuity, a little bit of barley husk, a little bit of sweetness. It's just a flat out Pilsner, right? But it's just done so well. I'm gonna nine. Shit, I don't know. Wow, and it actually carries a really nice sweetness to it. Right up front, then you get your barley flavor, then mega hops. Oh, this is a hard one to rate. I don't want to underrate it. That's awesome. Shit. I'm going to 10 it out of 11. Some people may disagree. I don't know. It is it's a very nice beer. It's absolutely well done. I know I like unfiltered Pilsners if I can get them. But this one for a filtered Pilsner, and that's just what it is, so you can't really knock it for that. But this is definitely one of the best Pilsners I've ever had in my life. Especially if you're considering that it's a filtered one. It's definitely in the top two or three for sure. So you might want to try this one. I suggest picking it up. And I'm out. Yeah.